This is Maria.
And that is Hester. Playing in a recorded concert, or in any other sort of chamber ensemble, or in a rock band, is all about teamwork.
Today we present no less than 20 tips to rehearse together in an efficient way and to create positive group dynamics. We hope you find them useful.
Perhaps you have even more tips for us and for other ensembles around the world. If you do, leave them in the comments section.
To feel that we belong in a team as an ensemble, it is good to discuss a couple of things. For example, what do all members have in common? What is your common goal? Do you want to specialize on a specific style period or a specific style of music? What makes you a good team? What is your common dream? How does working together make you feel? Can you think about any qualities that you have in your daily work life that you can bring to your ensemble? These questions are a very good starting point to also think of a name for your ensemble, or even to write a short statement defining your group. If you work on this together, you will certainly feel part of a team.
It is usually a very good idea to have long-term goals for your ensemble. For example, which program are you going to work on during the entire season, but also even beyond? Which instruments would you like to buy in the next 5 years? What are your dreams? Would you like to make a CD recording or a professional video recording? Dream big. So if you think in 5 years I want to play 40 concerts a year, you can always adjust your goal later, but if you have it, you'll have the drive to start looking how to make it come true.
Establishing short-term goals is also very, very important. It's like a checklist you can check. Done, done, done. Short-term goals you can think of are deciding which pieces you want to play in the next few rehearsals and making a detailed rehearsal schedule. Setting the goals per piece. For example, you want to improve bar 22 in this rehearsal because it was always a mess before, and you can again check the box because you did it.
While it is a very good idea, as we just mentioned, to set short and long-term goals, it is also a great quality of an ensemble to be flexible. If things don't go exactly as you planned, whether it's long or short-term, don't be afraid of changing your plans and thinking creatively together how you can solve any situation so that you are always strong as a team.
Usually it's more fun and productive to start your rehearsal with a low-pressure activity, like for example group exercises in a circle, improvisation games. If you don't know what we are talking about, you can check for example episode 6 on group exercises with contemporary techniques, episode 19 for a technical workout with your ensemble, or episode 1, how to share a melody. These activities will help you to develop as a group without immediate pressure. To end your rehearsal with a good feeling, it's also nice to end with a piece you all know very well. It's nice to end with something you really like and go home with a very positive feeling.
Booking the rehearsal space, listing which instruments you need, figuring out where to get the sheet music, ordering it, copying it, organizing concerts, printing posters, designing posters and flyers, and spreading the flyers, and making an event on Facebook. All of these things and more are part of what it is to be an ensemble player. Divide all these tasks, which are not purely musical, among all the members of the ensemble as evenly and as fairly as you possibly can. Take into account the availability, the talents, and the possibilities of everyone, but make sure everyone is involved.
If your ensemble does not have an artistic director, the artistic decisions are divided among the members. Try different models of leadership in your ensemble and decide upon which one works best. All members bring suggestions spontaneously. Each member of the ensemble takes artistic responsibility for one piece. or something in between. There's one person who coordinates the artistic decisions within the piece, but the other members can contribute and make suggestions on the go.
If you decide to go for the more democratic model of rehearsal, it is important that you take all ideas that are proposed equally seriously. So when someone comes with a proposal, make sure you try it out, then you talk about it, and then you decide if you are going to take it on board or not. This takes more time, but on the other hand, it will bring more ideas on the table. It will make everyone feel really involved and taken very seriously.
This is an obvious one. When we have group rehearsals, we work on all aspects of ensemble playing. And if all the members are individually well prepared, you are guaranteed of a more productive and efficient rehearsal. Bear in mind that preparation starts with practicing your own line very well, but it does not need to stop there. For example, listen to a recording of the piece to get a picture of the total sound. In this way, you can practice counting your rests and you can start to realize what kind of interaction your line has with other voices in the piece.
Help creating an atmosphere of concentration during the rehearsal. This doesn't mean that you have to be all stiff and silent and that you should feel under pressure. You can be relaxed and you can make a joke, but what we mean is never lose your focus. Listen very well to what's going on in the rehearsal. Keep track of where we are in the music, and if for a while you don't need to play yourself, pay attention to what your colleagues are doing, listen to them, you may get inspiration for your own playing, or you may be able to give them tips and send inspiration back.
Accept mistakes with patience, because they are part of music making. And talking about them too much or pointing them out too much will not help and will maybe even create tension or pressure, which is unnecessary. So if you notice that your colleague makes a mistake 3 times in a row, kindly point it out to them and help them find a solution. Be encouraging and supportive so that your colleague will get more confidence and self-esteem.
When you work with a teacher or a professional conductor, very often you will notice that they work in short sections. Often you will only get to play the complete composition when you get to the end of the session. Working in logical sections is very helpful and a very efficient way to rehearse, because you can focus on specific details, but the stretch is not so long that you lose overview of things. You can get to know exactly and to practice exactly how you want the piece to sound.
Every time you repeat a piece, a section, or even just a couple of bars, always know the reason why you are doing this. And never just repeat it again for the sake of repeating. For example, we want to improve coordination for this section. Or it's about the tuning of the first chord in bar 22. If you are the one who came up with the instructions, make sure that you are very clear in what you want.
Practice a difficult passage in as many ways as you possibly can. The more different ways, the quicker you get there. Practice with different articulations in different tempi, build up the composition from top to bottom or bottom to top. Practice a couple of specific bars in a loop and then put them again into the bigger context. In this way, you're gonna have more concentration and you are going to avoid falling into a routine that may feel boring.
Think of ways in which you can access external feedback. For example, inviting a teacher to a session, attending a course or a workshop with your ensemble, or showing one of your recordings to a professional musician. Your audience will also give you very valuable feedback. After a concert, ask them what they like the most and if they have any suggestions. Collect all comments and discuss them together and make a plan of action based on the tips you got.
It's nice to have a little reflection on how a rehearsal went. This doesn't need to be a very formal meeting in which everybody brings their ideas, but you can simply think a little bit about it on your way home or over a drink in the bar with your colleagues. When the experience is fresh, if you talk about it, you're probably going to come to new ideas and things that you want to try in the next rehearsal. Write them down and try them out.
If you have ideas for the ensemble, don't keep them to yourself, but talk to your colleagues or your artistic leader. Sometimes we get a little bit stuck in our own habits of rehearsing, doing things over and over and over again, and we need new inspiration. So if you have new ideas, bring them on!
giving a compliment to a colleague who just played something very beautifully, thanking someone who went through some trouble to organize something for the ensemble, or first talking about what you really, really enjoyed about tonight's performance. Those are really good things to do. By focusing on the positive, you are going to be more and more proud of what you produce together.
When you do not agree with an idea or you have a critical note to someone, be clear but kind. Think constructively. And for me, there's always a golden rule. Always have an alternative in mind, the way you like to change it. In this way, you can be constructive, be clear, but still show appreciation for the input your colleague gave.
Last but not least, for any sort of collaboration between human beings, communication is essential. In the daily communication, make sure that you always inform your colleagues about practical things like your availability, if they have a question about your planning, if you cannot make it once to a rehearsal. Always communicate in time and people will appreciate and know that you are trustworthy.
As soon as you feel that there is an important issue to discuss, first bring it up with the person in question.
By the way, do you have 10 minutes after the session? Because we need to discuss something.
As we already mentioned before, we are curious if you have any additional tips for a good rehearsal atmosphere and effective rehearsal time. Please leave your comments below.
We are also curious to know if your own consorts and ensembles have a name, have a slogan, have a statement. You are also very welcome to tell us about it in the comments. We can tell you about a couple of projects we had in the past and that you may not yet know and tell you where their names came from.
I used to have a trio called Tritone and we had a special setting with flute, harp and recorder. And we played mainly contemporary music, also compositions written for us, but also some arrangements of romantic music and very early medieval music in a very creative way. With the name Tritone, first of all because we are a trio, and second of all we liked the interval tritone the most of all, so therefore we thought it was suitable to name ourselves after the most beautiful interval in the world.
I also had a trio and we called ourselves Aerodynamic, and this is a name which has also very obvious connotations with aero, air, the air of the voice and the two recorders that form the ensemble. Dynamic, because we hope to be a dynamic ensemble playing early and contemporary music, making the air move and vibrate and produce interesting excitement in the brains and the hearts of our listeners.
We say our goodbyes, and remember you still have a couple of days to enter our quiz.
Check out the end of episode 34 for the questions and the instructions, and next week Monday we will tell you who the winner is.
Bye bye.